In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a spiral twister text with a single mask and few animators. So we are starting with this spinning beer glass with tons of smoke. This is courtesy of Adobe Stock, which means it is a free clip. You can download it as well. I'll put a link in the description for everything that I will show you here. So if you want, you can follow along. Anyhow, I'm just going to pause the playback, switch to the horizontal type tool and click, let's say, over here and type in the line Happy Hour Soho, which here in the UK stands for Small Office, Home Office, just in case you are wondering. I'm also going to add a special character. So here on the Mac, I'll hold the Option key down and press the digit 8, which is going to add this square, and then I'll add another space. Anyhow, I need a few copies from this text. So I'm going to open up the text properties and then twill down the text until I see the source text. I'll hold down the Option, Alt on Windows, and click on the stopwatch to enable an expression. And I'll start to type the word repeat. After Effects should help me. This is the expression that I want. And inside those parentheses, I'll put the digit 6, which means that After Effects is going to repeat this text 6 times, which is great because I can still edit the first line. Let me just show you. I'll double click on it. It's only going to highlight the text that I entered. And if I need, I can modify it. All right, so this should do, but again, we can add more copies if we need to. Okay, I'm going to close the source text, select the text layer, and then click and hold on the rectangle tool and switch to the ellipse tool. I'll hold down the shift and draw this circle somewhere over here, more or less in the middle of the screen. Now I can close the masks section and open the path options for the text. And near the word path, I'm going to marry it to this mask. I'll close the path options and I'll add few animators. First, I'll click near the word animate on this little arrow and enable pair character 3D, which is super important for everything else in this recipe to work. Now I'll return to the same menu and from the animate option, I'm going to start with the rotation animator. I'm immediately going to select animator 1, press return on the keyboard and name it rotate so I know what I'm doing because I'm going to add few more. For the X rotation, I'm going to highlight the degrees here and enter 90 degrees. And this, of course, is going to rotate the text towards us. We can't really see it, but we can change the anchor point, and I want the anchor point to be in the dead center of this mask. And to do it, I'll hold down the Command key here on the Mac, Control on Windows, and double click on the Pan Behind tool. And this is just going to help us in a moment when we are going to animate it. But first, we need to change the entire rotation for the layer. So under the transform for the entire layer, I'm going to open it up and change the X rotation this time to negative 90 degrees. And now the text is facing towards us. Now make sure that the text layer is selected. This is very important because we want to create another animator. So I'm going to go to the animate menu and I'll add a position animator. I'll close the rotate, I'll select animator 1, which is now the position 1, and I'm just going to name it so I'll know what it does. Next, I'm going to play only with the Z value. So let's start with a value of 400, and then to create the illusion of a cylinder climbing spiral text, I'll open up the range selector 1 for the position animator. I'll also open up the advanced section, and I'll change the shape from square to ramp up. And because it's ramping up, it creates this spiral climbing up text. Okay, let's close the advanced here, as well as the position properties. And let's revolve the entire thing by adding an expression for the transform of the layer, the Z rotation this time. So I'll hold down the Option or Alt, click to enable an expression, and I'm going to use time times 100. I'll click somewhere outside to approve it and press spacebar to preview the animation. Nice. Now, all we need to do is make it climb up. And we can do it just by animating the position. So I'll enable a keyframe for the position of the entire layer. And towards the end, let's go to 9 seconds over here. I'm going to raise it only on its Y axis. And of course, we can fiddle with it in a later stage, but this is how it looks right now. Now, it's kind of weird that the text is already visible at the beginning, so I'm going to add another animator, and this one is going to be animated. So I'll drill up the transform. I'll make sure again the text is selected, go back to the animate menu, and add an opacity animator. Before I'll start doing anything, I'm just going to name it opacity. So again, I'll know what it does. I'll change the opacity value to 0. And then I'm going to open up the range selector. I'll create a keyframe for the start, which is now set to 0. And then I'll go to, let's say, 5 seconds over here and set it to 100. And this is going to reveal the text coming from behind the glass. Although right now everything is above everything, meaning that the text is just doing this number, but the glass is not intertwining with it. So to help us sell the effect, we'll need to mask the glass as well as convert it to a 3D layer so those two 3D layers can interact with each other. So let me show you how to do it. I'll return to the beginning and I'll duplicate another version of the footage. I'll bring it above the text. I'm going to make it a 3D layer, and then I'll grab the pen tool and just create a very rough mask around the edges of the glass. You don't need to be super precise here. Just make sure that you are defining the edge or the shape of the glass. So something along those lines should suffice. All right, I'm going to open up the masks option, and under mask number one, make sure to create a keyframe for the mask path. And then let's move to 3 seconds and see if we need to make any modification. I think it's looking quite good. So let's move, I don't know, to the end, I guess, and then return to the selection tool. The mask is still selected, so I can just move the entire thing. There is a slight movement over here, and this is what I'm trying to compensate for. And as we can see, because this is now a 3D layer, it's interacting automatically with the text. And I just want to show you how this works from a different angle. So I'll click and hold on the active camera pop-up menu and change to custom view 1. And as you can see, we have this flat 3D card of the cutout of the beer glass, and the spiral text is orbiting or rotating, I should say, around it. Very lovely. Because this is a real 3D object, we can actually use some advanced features inside After Effects. So I'll press Escape to return back to the active camera, although I don't have an active camera. So maybe I will add one by going to the layer menu and choose New Camera, making sure that Depth of Field is enabled. And I'm going to use this preset of 50 millimeter. I'll click OK. And then what I want to do is first deal with the appearance of the text. And by that I mean, I just want to make sure that we're not going to see it coming from both sides. For that, I'll select the text, press U to see the keyframes. And what I need to do is just move this keyframe to somewhere over here, so around 7 seconds and 15 frames, I think, in my case. So the text is just coming from behind the glass, giving us this nice appearance. Now, everything looks very sharp. We can, of course, fiddle with the mask feather if we want, just to soften the edges a bit. But I don't think that this is the problem. The problem is that we have a shallow depth of field here. And because we are using this system, we can actually open up the camera options and change the focus distance, aperture, and blur level to try and mimic what we are seeing over here. So I'm just going to start raise the blur level, and then I can change the focus distance. Now, if I want to see a visual indication, I can switch back to custom view one and just move the focus distance so we can see the plane itself. Let's place it over here for the time being, return to the active camera. And then if I'm going to change the aperture as well as the blur level, I think we need to give it a more generous blur. We can see how this is going to impact the text. So the text which is behind the glass is becoming more blurred than the text which is in front of it. Okay, the last thing that I want to do is integrate the smoke so it will look as if it is swirling between the text layers here. I think it will help to sell the effect even better. So I'll select the original footage, press Command or Control D again to duplicate another version. And to isolate only the smoke, I'm going to go to Effect, and under the keying category, I'll add the Extract effect. And just to see what I'm doing, I'll solo the layer, and then I'll make a bit more room for the histogram. Grab the upper square here for the black point and start to move it until I'll see more or less just the smoke on the table. And then I'll add a bit more softness by changing the lower rectangle, something like this. All right, now we'll need to take this and bring it above all the other layers. And this is very important. We need to make sure that this layer is 3D as well. Otherwise, it will break the 3D render order. And now you can see that this smoke, which is isolated on this layer, is appearing between the spiral text, which I think helps to sell the effect that everything is combining naturally together. And this is it. So let's go to the beginning, maximize the composition panel, and preview this comp. And just so you'll see that this is not a one-trick pony, I'm going to escape out of full screen, return to the project panel, and show you two additional examples. I've got this one, which is a time-lapse shot of an apricot branch, and I'm using the same approach here to create this nice spiral text. Another example is the story of tape. And I think this example helps to demonstrate why this approach is more flexible than using the CC cylinder effect, which in this case I've used on the BBC4 logo. And because it is closer to us, it doesn't need to be blurred. Compare it to these two texts, which are above this left reel, and these are using the same technique that I showed you. And thanks to the fact that I'm using the camera depth of field, we can see that the text can come in and out of focus. So let's maximize this and play the entire thing from the beginning. So this is it for this tutorial. I hope these techniques will help you with your work. As always, thanks for watching. Take care, and I will see you soon in the next one.